The following feature presentation is part of the Skywalking Network.
This is what you can look forward to on our year-end wrap-up episode 234 of Skywalking Through Neverland. Even divisiveness in fandom.
Where is this divisive in fandom? Have I missed something in 2018?
Okay, Richard. What do you think?
The Skywalking Force.
Woo! Here's Spider-Man.
Here's John Spider-Man.
Having meaningful discussions with my 15-year-old daughter about Star Wars in general and the Force in particular while I chauffeured her to and from dance and cheer.
It didn't meet my expectations. Is that a bad thing? I would say not.
Yeah, because that'll hopefully unify fans, you know, have everyone talking about the same thing. So it'll change that conversation.
Did 2018 really happen? Did we really argue about all that stuff?
Are you ready?
Welcome to Neverland.
Here we go.
A long time ago, in a galaxy far, far away.
To all who come to this happy place, welcome. Disneyland is your land.
When I first made Star Wars, everybody in Hollywood said, well, this is a movie Disney should have made.
You're more than just fans. You're family.
About family, and that's what's so powerful about it.
Hey.
You use a bird to write with. It's called tweeting.
When we visit the world of Disney, we never grow old. It's a Peter Pan, never, never land that keeps us young in heart.
This is Jedi Master Obi-Wan Kenobi, and you are skywalking through Neverland. I have a good feeling about this.
Hey, Skywalkers, and Happy New Year. Hey, are you ready to look back on 2018 with the highs, lows, surprises, and what we're looking forward to in a galactic 2019? Well, if so, then we want to welcome you to
Skywalking Through Neverland.
We are your enthusiastic podcast destination for the many decades of your Star Wars, Disney, Marvel, and holiday fandom. I am Richard Woloski, your tour guide through the many decades of fandom. But everyone, please say hello to my sweetie wife, Sarah.
Hey, hey, Skywalkers! I am so excited to be here in 2019 with all of you. So, Richard.
Yes, yes.
Let's give them a big Wookiee hug to our family of Skywalkers. We want to thank you for listening to the show every week. And if you've listened to us in 2018, thank you. If you're just listening to us for the first time now in 2019, thank you even more. And we want to say hi to all our face huggers who are watching live on Facebook.
Hey, right, face
now.
Huggers. Happy New Year.
Yay.
Kevin Reitzel just joined us. Tati Perez is there. Matt Clifton. A whole lot of people that I couldn't read the screen because my glasses fell off.
Oh, that's true. Well, we just love it when you share our joy in this adventure through fandom. Now, we are recording this episode.
Our first episode of 2019.
Uh-huh. From Long Beach, California.
On January. It's January the 2nd, isn't it?
Yes. January. What were you going to say?
I didn't know what day it was. Oh. We're 48 hours into the new year and I'm already very far behind.
It's true.
Don't even ask me what day it is.
Well, I do have the time.
No, you don't.
I do. In fact...
No, you don't. You never have the time.
Tati just reminded me and I have the time.
Thank you, Tati.
And here we go. You
okay,
ready?
Ready.
It's 1:29. Good afternoon.
Yay, Minnie Mouse.
Well, thank you. Thank you, Minnie Mouse.
Aww.
All right, now let's get into this, Sarah. This is our sixth annual year in review episode.
Oh my goodness.
We're going to look at the highs, the lows, the surprises, and what we're looking forward to in 2019. And as always, we're going to be looking at some hashtags.
Yes.
How can we hashtag 2018?
Wait, what's your number?
Yeah. You know what? Call Trisha. Call Trisha and ask her what her number is.
We should say, because Trisha's been on every year for these wrap-ups, but she is currently on a cruise out of the country, so she won't be joining us.
And the excuse is?
That's the excuse. And she went on the Sound of Music tour, you guys. I'm so jealous yet happy for her, because it's an awesome tour.
Okay. That is a good excuse.
Yes.
All right, Trisha, have a good time. There's always 2019. So with that, Sarah, let's go ahead and jump into our look back, our skywalking look back into 2018.
So let's start out with our high points of 2018.
Start with the positives.
Yeah, yeah. So Richard, what is your high point?
I can sum it up in one word: Solo, A Star Wars Story.
That's more than one word.
It's one thought. It's one awesome, excellent film.
I've been running scams on the street since I was 10.
But the high point in that the film was fantastic. I loved every minute of it. It was fun. It was a callback to Lawrence Kasdan's Silverado Western days.
Definitely.
And we got new character development from the characters we've known for 40 some odd years. We got to meet new characters. We got to see the Kessel Run. There's a back match. Everything I've always wanted to know about Han Solo was right there in the movie. Everything I've always wanted to see, I should say, was right there. And I just loved it from minute one to the very, very last minute.
Awesome. Okay. Well, I do have to agree with you. Honestly, like looking back between The Last Jedi and Solo, I'd have to say that I enjoy watching Solo more.
Well, Solo was not as heavy as The Last Jedi.
Yeah.
The Last Jedi, you need like a nap right in the middle because it's such a heavy, heavy film.
Okay.
But Solo, it's just wall-to-wall fun.
It is. It is.
Yeah. All right. So now, how about any other high points in 2018?
Okay. Well, one of the high points I thought was Ralph Breaks the Internet. So Wreck-It Ralph 2. I thought that was a really fun film, really smart. And also, I just love how they incorporated the Disney princesses and had commentary on them, too. Like how they all mention, oh, what mom? Like they don't have moms and all this stuff that's like intrinsic to Disney films, and they make fun of it, but at the same time really show you, hey, there might be something wrong here. But I also love the way that the movie really made you think about the internet and like what it does to society, and even like brings out insecurities in people and maybe even divisiveness in fandom.
I'm not sure what you're talking about.
I know.
Where is this divisive in fandom? Have I missed something in 2018?
Oh, we'll get to that.
Cue sarcasm alert.
Yeah. All right. So do you have another high point, Richard? Yeah,
I would say Infinity War.
Oh.
I loved it the first time we saw it, and we just watched it last night, and I loved it even more.
Mm-hmm.
To me, it wasn't as good as Solo, because I've got more of a personal nostalgic connection to Solo, of course.
Right.
But it made me really want to see Endgame that much more.
Thanos did exactly what he said he was going to do. He wiped out 50% of all living creatures.
And then when you watch it again, there's so many more things you'll pick up on, because they'll mention the snap a few times.
Yes.
So the first time you're watching it, it's like, okay, so Thanos can snap. So what?
Right.
But now, oh, you hear it now and you know that's the end. If you see Thanos snap, you know that's not a good thing.
And then there's one moment in the film. Well, I guess spoiler alert, we should mention this. But there's one moment in the film where Doctor Strange actually uses the word endgame.
We're
in the endgame now, he mm-hmm. says. And that's now the new name of Infinity or
Avengers 4 Infinity War Part 2.
Yeah, endgame. So yes. Now everyone can just say endgame. It's a much easier hashtag. Mm-hmm. There you go. Okay. Well, I have one more high point of 2018, and that would be the Marvel Rising series and the figures that go along with it. Because, I mean, the series itself, it's so diverse, not just in like ethnicity, but also like the body shapes and the sizes of these characters, including, and the figures too, just have all these different sizes. They're tall, they're small, they're short, they're thin, they're curvy. They're just everything. So I think that's a really cool win in part of Marvel.
I was going over some of our Facebook photos from 2018.
Yes.
And I would say a majority have either the Forces of Destiny dolls or the Marvel Rising dolls.
Yeah,
yes.
Yeah.
Well, we put this out on Facebook in our group and our page about the Skywalkers' high points and low points and getting their commentary on the year past and the year moving forward. But let's read the high point as according to Matt Clifton.
Here we go. He says,
the Clone Wars 10th anniversary panel and that little announcement at the end of it. This is at Comic-Con.
Right. And he's talking, of course, about how they announced that Clone Wars will return for a final season.
Something
super
we never,
exciting.
We never thought we would get. I was excited about the Clone Wars 10th anniversary panel myself, but
yes.
I never in a million years thought this would ever be coming.
Yeah. Now, Reynold Gobiel, he says his high point is Solo.
Nice.
Star Wars Celebration tickets.
Mm-hmm.
And my new wonderful job.
Yeah.
Awesome.
Reynold, if you're watching right now, what is this wonderful new job?
Yeah, we don't know.
Patrick Izzo says, for his high point, there were two. How great Avengers Infinity War was, and how surprised and how great a film Solo was. How could you be surprised, Patrick?
Yes, he says, I'm not a fan of these backstory movies that are being planned and was skeptical about Alden playing Han Solo, but man, what a ride. The movie was fantastic, and Alden did embody a young 20-something Han Solo brilliantly.
And that's the one thing everyone was so worried about. Will he be Harrison Ford? No, he shouldn't be Harrison Ford. He should be Han Solo. And he did that perfectly.
All right, so let's share what Garrett Sessions says about his high point, and that is having meaningful discussions with my 15-year-old daughter about Star Wars in general and the Force in particular while I chauffeured her to and from dance and cheer.
Wow.
Practice, I'm sure. Wow. That's cool. It's awesome, like, having young people kind of have a different spin or they have a different point of view of these things. So it's great talking to them, and it's a great way to expand your point of view.
I'm wondering how far apart the home was to the wherever he was chauffeuring his daughter, because to talk about the Force in like, what, 10, 15 minutes? In chunks?
Yeah.
Wow.
You can do it.
Okay. We'll have to do that as a series.
All right, so Michelle says that one of her high points was Star Wars Night at Disneyland.
Oh, we missed that. What? That was on May the 4th, wasn't it?
It was near
Michelle,
there.
Was
I think
on?
It was May the 5th, and that's why we couldn't go, because we had something planned already.
Right. The night of May the 3rd to May the 4th, or the night of May the 4th to May the 5th?
Yeah, I'm not sure. But she also says that the Solo line with liningup.net was awesome, and yes, definitely agree with that. Although those are more personal fandom highlights, which is coming up.
Which is coming up very, very soon.
Right now, right?
Yes, yes. You know what? One thing with that, when
yes.
we were waiting in line with liningup.net for Solo, I wanted to dress in like big, heavy clothing, because whenever we would wait with liningup.net at the forecourt of the, oh boy, Chinese Grauman's.
Nope.
No
Grauman's, no
man's.
Right? TCL.
TCL, Element OP Theater. It would always be December. So I was conditioned to dress very heavily.
Yes.
So you were like, Rich, you don't need to wear two parkas and long sleeve shirts and ski pants.
No, not at all. All right. So let's move on to our personal fandom highlights for 2018. And those of you who are watching live, feel free to share them.
All right. Hold on. This just in. Michelle said it was May the 3rd. Into May the 4th.
Star Wars Night.
Star Wars Night at Disneyland, yes.
Okay. Yeah. I remember we had like something like at a library or something.
Well, we
going
were in
on.
Oceanside doing
yes.
a show.
That's what it was.
Ugh. However, we're going to be there this year.
Yes.
Big things planned, I think. All right. So, personal fandom highlights.
Okay, Richard. What do you think? What's our number one?
The Skywalking Force.
Woo! Skywalking
yes.
Force.
Yes, of course. We want to thank the Skywalking Force for helping in and chipping in to help support the show. It has gone a long, long way. The camera arm that's holding the camera right now was
yep.
paid for by the Skywalking Force, and the new microphones we got. What are they called? The stereo
binaural yes.
headset, and just for all of the. The Libsyn, and so many things, so many of these bills are adding up, and so, so happy that the Skywalking Force stepped in
yes.
and helped us.
Yes, thank you so much, Skywalkers.
That calls for one more big Wookiee hug.
To our family of Skywalkers.
Yes, yes. All right, what you got, Sarah?
Okay, so personal fandom highlight for me, really, when I think about it, when I went to the Mary Poppins Returns press conference and I dressed in my Mary Poppins lovely dress, it's Emily Blunt saying, "You look awesome." When I was trying to ask a question, she like interrupted me, said, "You look awesome." And then I think it was the director, Rob Marshall, who was saying, "Oh, where, what is that penguins on your skirt?" It was so cute. So I just, it was fun. Little Twitter-pated moment there.
It's fun when the cast and crew take an interest in you.
Yeah. Yeah.
That's definitely a personal moment there.
Yeah. Do you have one?
Oh, I got lots.
We'll go back and forth.
And once again, for anyone, the face huggers,
yes,
if you have a personal fandom moment, please, please throw it out there. Hey, Eric Walker, he's watching.
Yeah.
All right. I would say the visit from our good friend Details in October.
Yes.
And getting to take him on Star Tours for the first time. And for those of you who don't recall who Details is, he was Quaid Tulsight in Solo, and he was various characters in Force Awakens and Rogue One and Last Jedi. And he decided to pay LA a visit. Of course, he had to come and see us.
And it was during Halloween season.
Yes, yes. And he never had Halloween before.
No.
So not only did we take D on his very first Star Speeder ride at Star Tours, and wouldn't it be really funny if he was the rebel spy?
Oh.
Yeah, would have been really funny.
Really funny.
But you know what? Fine, I'll acquiesce to D since it's his first time. But we also got to take D around and show him Halloween.
Yeah.
We introduced Halloween to D.
Because he's from England.
Yeah, so they don't have Halloween really. Mm-hmm. We went to the Haunted Hayride in Los Angeles, and we got to record him the first time he went trick-or-treating.
Yeah.
It was in one of these spook mazes, and one of the mazes was called trick-or-treat, so you get to knock on doors and the monsters would pop out and hand you a lollipop.
Yes.
That to me was a personal fandom. You know what? Just a personal highlight itself.
Definitely. Definitely. All right. I have another personal highlight.
Please.
And that is when we saw Solo in the D-Box seats.
Oh,
remember
that was,
this? So it's like those theater seats that move and like shake and the lights strobe and all this stuff.
Heaven forbid you're drinking one of those big super gulps when the seat tosses you around and does a shoulder roll and bounces you from wall to wall.
Right.
They should really put a warning when you're buying these tickets.
Yeah.
Yeah, you can't eat or drink during these films because those seats really will bounce you around.
But I really loved that, and it really stuck with me because, for one thing, I saw it with you, and my parents were there too. And what really got me is it just seemed like this is like a precursor to Star Wars Galaxy's Edge. Mm-hmm. And like the rides were going to be in there. So it was like this tiny slice of what Galaxy's Edge is going to be.
It was very immersive.
Yeah, yeah, definitely.
Because when they're going through the Kessel Run, you're
swinging
back and forth and jolting, and the lights are flickering in your face.
It's so awesome.
For me, it was our Lost Con panel we did a few weeks ago, and we did a salute to the Star Wars Holiday Special for its 40th anniversary.
Yay!
And it was so much fun teaching people who had never seen the special, didn't know anything about it. They were there and they wanted to learn, what is it about this special I should know? And they had only, unfortunately, heard the negative things, so we got a chance to tell them all the good things about the holiday special.
And we even shared some from the special itself. You know, we had video and
had
things,
video,
too.
Video, yeah. Yeah. And
really comprehensive look.
We did do a video recording, and I've been working on this since last of November, but holidays came and took all our time. And so that will be up, I want to say, very, very soon.
Okay. Yeah. Because.
Yeah.
But within probably the next week.
I would say next 2 weeks.
Okay.
We'll have our panel up there from Lost Con. And Bob Miller joined us. He wrote, which is right over there. Hold on. I'm going to go get it. I want to make sure I get Bob's books correct.
Okay.
So Bob Miller wrote the Star Wars Historical Source Book.
Okay.
This one right here I'm showing everybody. Great, great, great source book. A lot of research can be done with that book. And he wrote, May the Facts Be With You.
Nice.
And he gave us an extra copy for a future giveaway, which we'll be doing very, very soon.
Ooh.
So Bob joined us, as well as Craig Miller, who worked publicity for Star Wars and The Empire Strikes Back. And he was around the Lucasfilm offices when they were doing the Star Wars Holiday Special. So he had some insight.
Yeah.
Oh, and speaking of Craig Miller, We want to thank Craig for inviting us to his New Year's Day party last night.
Yeah. It was super fun.
Yeah.
We met like-minded fans.
Yeah. And we were all sitting around the table and just enjoying each other's company and meeting new people. And someone had mentioned writing the novelization to The Empire Strikes Back. And I look over and there's Don Glute sitting there.
So that was cool. Now, Michelle wants to share a highlight, and that is when the Mandervillians invade Disneyland. That was a highlight. Yes, we had a really fun time meeting up with them and on our Festival of Holidays meetup at Disney.
Yeah.
So, and coming this year, oh, you bet we're going to have some Galaxy's Edge meetups. Because mm-hmm. the only way to stand in those lines is going to be with a group of people that you can talk to and chat to for however many hours.
Well, I'm sure we can record like 3 or 4 podcast episodes while waiting in those lines.
I agree.
They introduced us to that toffee cake thing that I devoured.
Yeah.
Love that thing, whatever it was.
I forget. All right. Well, I have one more personal highlight.
Okay.
And that is when Mark Hamill got a star on the Hollywood Walk of Fame. We got there super early in the morning. And thanks to lineingup.net, we got some amazing rail standing, you know, like standing right in the front row.
Oh, yeah. We could reach over the gate and just...
And touch Kathleen Kennedy.
Pat and Billy Lord in the head or...
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Yeah. Billy Lord, right?
Yeah.
It was amazing. And also, who was there giving dedication speeches, but George Lucas and Harrison Ford. And honestly, it was just so refreshing to not have them be grumpy and to have them share really heartfelt like emotions and stories about Mark Hamill. So
this was in March.
Yes.
And so it was right in front of the El Capitan Theater, and the El Capitan had teaser posters for Solo, and where I was standing, there was Harrison Ford standing about 15 feet away from the Solo poster, and I was trying to get a really good picture. That would have been the best picture of 2018 to get Harrison Ford standing in front of that Solo poster, but I just couldn't
get the right angle.
I couldn't get that focal length.
Okay, yeah.
Darn you, focal lengths.
So that was really cool. And the video that we shot from that, which we were at two different spots, so mm-hmm. we composited the video, and that can be found on our YouTube channel, youtube.com/skywalkingthroughneverland.
All right. I got one more personal moment.
Okay.
Personal fandom moment.
Okay.
And that was going to the Resistance press event.
Yeah.
Last September, mm-hmm. and got a chance to goof around and talk with my good buddy, Donald Faison. I call him my good buddy.
Oh, yes.
But he asked me not to.
Oh.
Love Scrubs, and I love Turk Turkelson and Scrubs, and I've always wanted to meet Turk.
And I don't know who had the higher energy level, you or him.
He was so happy.
He was. Yeah, it was really
His energy
really cool.
was up here. Mine was up here. All of ours were just so high, and he was just so excited about having a part in Star Wars Resistance, but his character, Hype Faison, named after him.
Yeah. So the name Faison will live forever in Star Wars lore.
So if you look at those pictures we took, there's Turk, Donald Faison talking.
Yep.
And there's me right behind him with a huge grin. It's a huge ear-to-ear smile.
Definitely a personal highlight. Well, let's share some Skywalker personal highlights here. So Joshua Jordan had a favorite personal moment, and he says, meeting Ashley Eckstein of her universe fame on my birthday and her making it special. And then also releasing not just one, but 2 issues of my comic, The Blue Flame Legends, and attending Claremont Comic-Con as an artist, which is his first time. So that's really awesome.
That's a great personal moment.
Yeah.
And he also finishes up by saying, Spider-Man Into the Spider-Verse. That has made a lot of people's lists.
Mm-hmm. So we need to see it.
We need to see that. We saw Bumblebee instead, and it was not a great moment in 2018. Yeah. All right, so Randall Gobiel has a personal moment, and that's helping Martin Keeler out with some action figures from the Winnipeg Toys R Us.
Toys R Us?
Oh. That must have been early last year.
Yeah.
Oh, Skywalkers helping Skywalkers.
Oh.
Gotta love that.
Yes.
All right. Garrett Sessions, he had a personal fandom moment, and that was realizing that a Jedi is most powerful when they realize that self-sacrifice is their ultimate duty, and they approach it with peace and purpose.
Nice.
That should be a hashtag for 2018.
Peace and purpose.
Yes, yes, yes.
Oh, and Jennifer says, favorite moment for us, meeting all when we were out there. Oh. Y'all are awesome. Aw.
My cousin's daughter. Hey, Jennifer.
Thank you, Jennifer.
Ooh. Say hi to Jonathan. All right. Another personal moment from the face huggers.
Yeah, Brian says, my personal highlights were seeing Solo, meeting Timothy Zahn, and multiple 501st troops at different local events. Awesome. Yeah, meeting Timothy Zahn. Oh.
Yeah, we cornered him at
Star Wars Celebration Orlando.
Was that?
Yeah.
2017?
It was 2017.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Doesn't really count then.
Yeah, no.
Not for us, but for you, Brian, yes.
That was a personal highlight for me in 2017.
Yes.
Yes.
Oh, the years are blending.
I know. They totally are. But awesome, Brian. Thank you for sharing those.
All right. Well, you know what? You can't really go into the high points without maybe touching on the low points to really accent on how great those high points were.
Well, they wouldn't be high points unless there were low points.
Yes.
So, you know what?
You got to get both sides.
Yes. So, personal fandom low point for me was the cancellation of Timeless. Well, and it was so prolonged because like all the other TV shows were renewed or canceled and no one knew about Timeless and we were all tweeting for like a month and then finally the announcement came, oh no, it's canceled. And we were very sad for a little bit.
For you Skywalkers who don't know, this was a great series that had two seasons starring Matt Lanter, Anakin Skywalker from the Clone Wars.
Right.
And it was all about these three people who would go back into time trying to bring down Rittenhouse, which was the organization, like the secret organization behind all the evil things that are going on today.
Right.
So how can you make sure that the evil doesn't happen, go back in time and fix it.
Yeah. And what was really cool about it is that these three people, you know, would go back and they'd go back to events that like you knew about, but you know, you'd get like a whole, you'd get into these events, like the assassination of Abraham Lincoln or Watergate and things like that, like all through history. And you get to learn a lot more about them, often through the eyes of someone who was underrepresented. Like I think of a black woman in the space race and things like that. So it was really, really neat.
And one of the best parts about it is hearing Matt Lanter make these Star Wars references.
Yes! Super awesome! And the chemistry between the three people who travel in time is awesome. Off the charts. And yeah.
Well, good I know stuff. This next thing made everyone's low points in 2018. And of course, that's the division of Star Wars fandom.
Absolutely.
I've been with Star Wars since day one back in 1977. And I've never, ever experienced what we're going through right now and all through 2018. Just because people didn't like The Last Jedi. All of a sudden, boom. That was the catalyst that brought out the worst in people. And I don't know why. Well, I do know why, but I don't want to dwell any more into that because it's just more of the same. And hey, if I have an opinion and you've got an opinion, that makes us different people.
Right.
Can you imagine if we all had the same opinions?
Right.
And if you didn't like the way things happened, well, you know, you're not going to love everything about everything in your fandom.
Right, right. And I think social media is really the catalyst for this division because on social media, people feel like they have a voice and then...
They should use it.
But they are a faceless voice. So they don't care what they say because it's not like... You wouldn't say the things you say on Twitter to a person's face.
Mm-mm.
You know, like you can get away with a lot more when you... And you can just block someone on social media. So, well, actually bouncing off of that, we should say that Garrett Sessions says his low point was Star Wars fandom turns into the Game of Thrones on social media.
That's a good way of putting it.
It is, including some factions using the Red Wedding as a template on how to treat people online.
Whoa. So if you haven't seen Game of Thrones and you haven't seen The Red Wedding,
well, we won't tell you.
That's pretty much how to crystallize and visualize the Star Wars fandom. Hashtag bloodbath.
Oh.
Yeah. And it really isn't fair what people are saying because we all want, if you have a voice, Great. But don't tear down each other. Mm-hmm. Just because we don't like what you like or hate what you hate. And if The Last Jedi didn't meet your expectations, did anything? The Empire Strikes Back did not meet my expectations because it was Empire was a very dark film. Where Star Wars was very light, we have something that's more personal. And as a 11-year-old, no, it didn't meet my expectations. Is that a bad thing? I would say not, because if it can exceed your expectations, then so much the better. Mm-hmm. And then everyone expected Return of the Jedi in 83 to be as dark as Empire, and that didn't meet people's expectations. That was a fantastic film, return back to the roller coaster that Star Wars was. And I don't even want to get into the Star Wars prequels because my point being that it's okay for something to not meet your expectations, but allow it to exceed your expectations. Mm. And for me, The Last Jedi, I would say exceeded my expectations because I didn't know what to expect. Of course, there's moments that if they had said, Richard, should we have Luke throw the lightsaber over his shoulder? I'd say, no, let's not go there. So there's things that we could always pick apart in anything.
Okay.
But if that's the way it goes, that's the way it goes.
Well, Patrick Izzo is actually one of the people who did not like The Last Jedi. In fact, he writes about his fandom low point. My low was The Last Jedi. I'm in the camp that was not happy with Rian Johnson's take on Luke, but you know what? It doesn't affect my fandom one way or another. Never Say Never Again was just a remake of Thunderball, but that one movie didn't make me no longer want to be a James Bond fan. You take the movies as they come and move on. Now I'm just hyped to finally get Episode 9 in 2019.
Yeah, that's a good point there. We were talking to some people last night, right? And Solo was a casualty in their dislike for The Last Jedi.
Well, he didn't like The Last Jedi, so therefore he has not seen Solo yet.
Yes, in protest for not liking The Last Jedi.
But it's different. It's a different movie, totally.
Yeah, I don't understand that.
Right.
Because it's not The Last Jedi 2. Mm-hmm. It's Solo. Give it a chance.
Right.
Erg. All right, now Matt Clifton and Laurie Lazat were on the same page here with Solo. And they said, with Solo box office, they canceled other Star Wars stories and no sequel to Solo.
Ah.
Bam, right there. That is a low, low, low point.
Yeah.
That's horrible.
Do, 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 do.
Yeah, just because one out of the 10th film, 10th theatrical Star Wars U.S. film, one doesn't do well, so you scream and run?
Yeah.
What kind of a business model is that?
Yeah,
Disney,
I don't get
call
that.
Us.
I mean, there's some Marvel films I haven't enjoyed as much. Heck, some Disney films I haven't enjoyed as much, but that doesn't make me stop watching Disney films.
Well, Ant-Man did not make as much as Solo. Mm. Ant-Man and the Wasp. So are we heading to the hills now? No, it did not.
Oh, my.
Mm-mm. Well. And people, and I brought this point up, and people have said, well, they weren't expecting that much out of Ant-Man as they were Solo. It's like, after Infinity War becoming the mega blockbuster it was, people were expecting more from all new Marvel movies.
Right.
And Ant-Man did not do as well as Solo. But people were excited for an Obi-Wan film starring Ewan McGregor.
That would have been amazing.
Maybe this was the one excuse Disney needed so they could put everything on television now.
Yep, exactly. Or, wait a minute. Their Disney Plus streaming service. Mm-hmm. All right, so shall we move on now?
Yeah, please.
Let's get out of the low points. Let's get out of this dungeon. And let's move on to the surprises in 2018. So, Richard, were there any surprises for you?
Clone Wars saved.
Woohoo!
All right, Rex. What's so important that you brought us all the way back here?
Hello, Master. It's been a while.
I'm going to go on to my next biggest surprise, and we're getting not just one, but two live-action Star Wars shows coming to Disney Plus.
Yes.
With The Mandalorian and the Cassian Andor variety show. No, it's not a variety show.
No.
It's the Rogue One prequel, starring Cassian Andor.
Right.
And Diego Luna is returning to play Cassian Andor. Huge surprise. That came out of nowhere.
It really did. Yeah.
I've been waiting since 1994. also dig out some of those Star Wars insiders where, starting in 94, they kept talking about this upcoming Star Wars live-action TV show.
Charles Halloran is saying an Obi-Wan series?
Yeah, because
it's not nothing confirmed.
No, nothing's confirmed.
Oh, okay.
But since they're not doing the Obi-Wan show,
right,
movie, that they might do it on Disney Plus,
like a miniseries.
Yeah, and you know what? Ewan McGregor did Fargo, that miniseries.
Well, miniseries are often like better because you can really get into the characters. You can have more story. Like,
yeah, yeah.
I'm great.
8 to 10 episodes,
right,
to really flesh out a story.
Mm-hmm.
So that would be the perfect way to do an Obi-Wan standalone.
Definitely.
I still want to see films. I'm still hating to think that Disney is so scared of their stockholders that they're not doing any more movies.
Mm.
Because after episode 9, who knows what's going to go on?
Right. We don't know.
Yeah. Everything's been pulled.
Wow. Okay. Well, we do have Star Wars Celebration and D23 Expo. And maybe they'll have some announcements.
Right, but okay, was that a surprise for you when you heard about?
Oh no, that's not a surprise. I'm just adding it as a.
Oh right. Oh, I am sure we're going to see the first episode of The Mandalorian.
Right,
Cassian, not too sure about, but I would bet anything that we're going to see the first episode of The Mandalorian.
That would be neat.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. All right, I'm going to bet $20 out of Sarah's pocket. That's what we're going to see.
I don't have a pocket right now.
Well, then we
so
all
win. So joke's on you.
Oh, hold on. Eric Warren just said, it's really the K2SO show.
That would be cool.
Oh, he's got to have K2SO with him. One of the breakout new characters from the new Star Wars films.
All right. So I had a surprise in 2018.
Let's hear it.
And it was how much I got obsessed with Timeless. Because honestly, I've not been that obsessive about something since I originally saw like the Star Wars films, Empire Strikes Back, Star Wars, and then I would rewatch them over and over throughout that summer. So I think I rewatched each Timeless episode 3 times.
No.
I listened to podcasts about them.
Maybe 4 or 5 times for each episode. What are you trying to kid?
And I would just like generally swoon over the show, and it was so much fun. So and it's awesome to know, honestly, that many fans felt the same as me, so much so that it was the fans who made the finale 2-hour Christmas episode actually happen with all our endless tweeting about Timeless saved. Save Timeless. Yes.
There's Clone Wars saved and there's Timeless saved.
Save Timeless, yes.
Yeah.
I know. So yeah, that was my surprise because I would dream about Timeless. I'd like wake up thinking about it. Yeah, mm-hmm. I was obsessed.
And Matt Clifton also says one of his biggest surprises of 2018 was Spider-Verse. We've got to go and see this movie.
Mm-hmm. Spider-Man Into the Spider-Verse.
All right.
I had never even heard of it until it was out. Mm-mm. And people were raving about it. It's crazy.
Well, I heard about it when we went to go see the screening for Mary Poppins Returns.
Okay.
And there was 2 lines, one for Mary Poppins and a humongous line for Spider-Verse.
That's right. It was our preview screening.
Yeah.
But the Spider-Verse was out. Okay. Wow.
I'm a Spider-Man fan, but I didn't know there was a Spider-Verse.
And apparently Chris Pine does the voice of Miles Morales, I think. So anyway, yeah, we got to see this.
Yeah. I wonder if Spider-Pig is going to be in Spider-Verse. Will Homer Simpson sing the Spider-Pig song?
Spider-Pig, Spider-Pig, does whatever a Spider-Pig does. Can he swing from a web? No, he can't. He's a pig. Look out. He is a spider pig.
Who says Spider-Man?
Who says Spider-Man? Your mom says Spider-Man.
Oh, is that who says that?
Yeah. It's like Lieberman or Goldman. Here's Mr. Spider-Man.
Here's Spider-Man.
Here's John Spider-Man. Oh, hold on. This just in. Michelle says that one of her biggest surprises for 2018 was Kaya winning the costume contest at Solo.
Yeah, wasn't she dressed as a little Lando?
As little Lady Lando.
Oh my gosh.
They had a costume contest and some really great costumes, but little Kaya won for Lady Lando in the Empire Strikes Back outfit.
Yeah. And Eric Warren says his surprise was the Spider-Man game. Nice.
Is that in Spider-Verse? Am I behind on Spider-Man?
Apparently we are.
Or is the... Could another title be for Spider-Verse, Spider-Man, since there's more, it's plural, so could the sequel to Spider-Verse be called Spider-Man? No, they couldn't because there's the Spider-Gwen.
Okay.
And she's not a man.
Apparently that Spider-Man game is a PS4 game.
All right, I'm trying to work things out here.
Yeah, it's not Disney Infinity, so I know nothing.
Oh, Michelle, you didn't give us a spoiler alert. She said no Spider-Pig. That's okay. That's okay. I didn't think Spider-Pig would be a part of it. All right, now, Sarah, if you could go back and tweet your 12-year-old self.
Yes.
About 2018.
Okay.
What would you tweet?
I would tweet, don't waste your money on boring clothes that have no IPs.
Really? That's what you would say?
I would. Save up all your money now. Save up all that lunch money because holy cow,
right
there was
now,
so much stuff.
Ashley Eckstein is smiling. All right. For me, if I could go back to 1981 when I was 12 years old.
Oh.
I would say, write everything down. I've always kept journals, so you know what? Maybe I did tweet my 12-year-old self because I've got like full journals of things I've written down.
Okay.
Or I would say, write things down in more detail with dates.
Right.
Because, you know, the older you get, the more you forget things. And it's like, wait a minute, did this happen
especially
this way?
Then.
Did this happen that way? So I'm really trying hard to remember things as they were. So I'm going through so many different journals. I'm Facebooking friends I had when I was a kid and say, hey, do you recall if this happened this way or that way?
Mm-hmm. Okay. Well, Jeff Birdsell says, I would go back and give myself lottery numbers. way to be all Back to the Future about that one.
Yeah.
Jeff.
Maybe, is Jeff really Biff?
Yeah,
Biff,
right?
Jeff, Biff? So, I would tell you to make like a tree and get out of here, Jeff, but we want you to stay.
Yes. That's
you,
so cute.
If you are the real Biff, let us know. DM us.
All right. So, now let's move on to the next question. What would be your hashtag for 2018?
I'm going to guess yours has got something to do with timeless.
Why, yes, Richard, it does. It's hashtag save timeless, because this literally was the hashtag I tweeted out the most, and it was in my profile. So, yeah, hashtag okay. Save timeless.
All right.
And it was saved for the most part.
You did a good job. All right, Matt Clifton said, exasperated sigh.
Aww.
Hashtag exasperated sigh.
Yes.
I hear you. Randall Gobiel says, hashtag 2018 roller coaster has come to a stop.
Oh.
Oh, boy.
And Joshua Jordan says, hashtag the good and the meh.
They're speaking your language, sweetie.
I know. I love it. What's yours, Richard?
My hashtag is hashtag the pendulum.
They all kind of say the same thing.
Yeah, this has been a really, really rough year, and the pendulum has swung so high.
Oh, so you're talking about, yeah.
When it comes to who's being offended, like this right, this is the straw that broke the offensive back here.
Okay, what is
all it? All right. The Princeton University a cappella group, the Tiger Tones, their longtime tradition has been banned.
Uh-oh.
And what tradition is this?
What?
Well, at the end of each rendition of Kiss the Girl from The Little Mermaid, a singer from the group would bring a male and a female audience member up to the stage.
Okay.
So far, so good. But they would encourage them to dance with each other and then do as the song says.
Kiss the girl. Sha-la-la-la-la-la, don't stop now, don't try to hide it, how you wanna kiss the girl? Sha-la-la-la-la-la, ain't that sad, you need no shame, too bad, you're gonna miss the girl. Sha-la-la-la-la-la, music play, do what the music say, go on and kiss the girl. Sha-la-la-la-la-la, don't be scared, you got the mood prepared, go on and kiss the girl.
And the Tiger Tones have now pulled the song from its act following a student newspaper column that suggested the song's lyrics, coupled with what could be an unwanted kiss, promote toxic masculinity?
They're singing Kiss the Girl.
Yeah.
It's a Disney song.
Now they're pulling a male and a female.
Right.
And encouraging the male to kiss the girl. But the girl, she's got every right to say no.
Yes.
I
don't know.
What? Help me out here. Help me. So I don't understand this.
I know.
I heard this and I thought it was a goof. So now anything can be offensive.
Right.
You know what? I'm offended at Twinkle Twinkle Little Star. How I wonder what you are? Why are you wondering? Why can't I just be? Why are you wondering?
Honestly, I'm offended by rap songs, which have worse lyrics than Kiss the Girl.
Well, if you want to get to that, you can be offended by all those cop-killing video games.
Yeah. Oh, my.
Skywalkers, help me. What's going on with this with Princeton? I think if someone just got a soapbox, they're going to use it.
Yes.
Skywalkers, what's really gone too far for you?
Oh, that's a good question.
Is it Baby It's Cold Outside?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, tweet at us, at Skywalking Pod. We'd love to know if there's something that's gone too far for your fandom or your...
Okay, yeah. And then Matthew Rumpf says, Kiss the Girl, social justice is just getting ridiculous. Why can things just be that? Exactly.
That's right.
You know what? I want to go back to my 12-year-old self and just say, you're not going to believe what 2018 is going to be. Don't say or do anything because it will come back. I could tell you what's going to happen. You'd never believe it. You would never, ever believe how far the pendulum is going to swing.
Peer pressure can lead to dangerous situations, not just for women, but for some men. Not every man wants to kiss the girl. Oh, that's very true, too.
Yeah. And you know what? Either one can say no for that Princeton tradition.
Yeah.
All right. Before I get too aggravated with all this.
Let's move on. Let's move on.
To the Constable Zuvio Award.
What is this? Well, this is basically disappointments in our fandom. Something that did not live up to expectations, much like Constable Zuvio.
What didn't live up to our fandom?
Well, Eric Warren has one. And he says it's the lack of an interview with the sidewalk Thor on a late night show featuring Avengers on a bus. Let's fill everyone in on this one, Richard.
All right, So I got a call from the James Corden show, and they needed some Avengers for this comical bit they were doing.
Yes.
This is the week that Avengers Infinity War was coming out. So I got a call to be Thor on the side of the road as the tour bus would drive by, and there was a Hulk, there was a Captain America. So we were being those Hollywood actors who are just looking to make some tips from tourists.
Right.
Okay. So we weren't told when we were hired for the job that the tour bus going past us was full of Avengers.
Yeah.
Like the real
actual
Avengers.
Actors from the film.
Chris Pratt, Zoe Saldana, Benedict Cumberbatch.
Like, I think there was like 10, 12 of them.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. And
Loki was there.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. Tom Hiddleston. Yeah.
So we waited outside because the tour bus was making other stops for about 4 or 5 hours.
Oh, my gosh.
Others are coming by and taking pictures with us. And then all of a sudden they said, okay, everyone in place. The tour bus is coming by. And it's coming by. And it's like, is that Robert Downey Jr. up there? It was the Avengers, which took us all by surprise.
Yes. No one knew.
And someone, I'm not sure who said this, but someone, they cut back to the tour bus and someone said, was that Chris Hemsworth down there? Talking about me.
Yeah. Yeah. So you were on screen for a total of like
three to four seconds.
Yeah.
But still a very fun story.
It is. Yeah. But so Eric was clearly upset that you weren't interviewed.
Well, there you go. There's my interview.
Yeah, I know.
There's the full story right there.
But fun addition to that story is after they were taken on the tour bus, all those actors were then led over to one of the hotels in Beverly Hills where I was there waiting at the press conference to see them all. So
yeah,
that was pretty cool.
I didn't go to the press conference because this job came in for the James Corden show. It's like, I want to do the James Corden show.
Yeah.
And the producer of the show later called me to do a solo bit.
Oh.
They wanted me as Chewbacca, but I didn't get the phone call in time, and they were shooting like 20 minutes. That's how Hollywood works.
Yeah.
We want you in 20 minutes. Like, I live in Long Beach. You're in Hollywood.
Sorry.
It'll take me 20 minutes to find my car keys.
Exactly.
So there was the Constable Zuvio Award, according to Eric Warren.
Yeah.
All right. So, Sarah, what is your Zuvio Award? Who does that go to?
A Wrinkle in Time.
A wrinkle and a waste of time.
I so loved this book growing up. It was such like a fuel for the imagination. And I think I read the series like 5 times growing up. And I was so looking forward to this film. And it just sucked. It just sucked. Like, there was nothing redeeming about this thing.
Well, come on. We saw the preview at D23 Expo.
Yeah.
It looked horrible.
I was still holding out hope until I saw it.
It was so miscast.
It really was.
And I didn't know anything about Wrinkle in Time, and I still don't. I didn't read the books. But I still knew that, wow, this is just horrible.
Yeah. Oh, well. Well, we won't dwell on that. So what is your Constable Zuvio Award, Richard?
Wait, hold on. Michelle is saying is this a disappointment? Yes. The decision by Disneyland to block out APs from access to Galaxy's Edge all summer without a signature annual pass?
Well, see, we...
What? This is news to me. What?
Well, I think what it is right now the annual passes for this year now are going to have 2 calendars to look at. One for one park, one for another. So, like, depending on what level AP you get, you might be blocked out of Disneyland Park, but still be able to go to DCA on any given day, and vice versa. But those are the lower levels. So if you do get the higher signature or signature plus, I believe you're still good for all the parks. So basically they, you know, making you, if you spend the most money for your AP, you get to go whenever you want.
Right, which pass do we normally get?
We usually get that signature, not the signature plus. So it depends, but yeah. So we have to talk about this because we're up for a renewal here. But we have been saving up our money for our annual passes.
So, yeah, because right now we are passless.
Yes. It feels so weird.
It feels like a certain part of my soul has been sucked away.
Right? It's crazy. Because they don't offer you any incentives now for renewing. So it's like, well, we might as well just buy our annual passes the next time we go instead of renew.
Okay.
All right. Woo. So is that our Constable Zuvio's? Or no?
No.
You have one.
I've got one and I hate going here. I really do. But my Constable Zuvio Award gets to be handed over to Star Wars Resistance. And I know it was written for a 6 to 8 year old audience, and I know that and I acknowledge that, but it wouldn't have taken much to make it universally loved. Now, in our podcast spinoff series, Resistance Flyby, we would go through what we liked, what we didn't like, and how easy it would have been to just slip in a line of dialogue to fill in a plot hole. And after coming off of Clone Wars and then Rebels.
Which just amped up the Star Wars goodness.
And plus Dave Filoni was attached to this.
Yeah.
And after speaking with all the actors and producers at the press event, we had such high hopes for Resistance.
And didn't really meet our expectations. I kind of share the Constable Zuvio Award on this one, unfortunately.
And, you know, there are a lot of cartoons that are made for the younger kids, but they appeal to the older crowd as well. So why can't this one over here?
Right.
Why can't Resistance really reach out to the older fans?
Mm-hmm.
And knowing that we're going to be watching it and judging it.
Right.
And make it universally loved.
Well, this is interesting. Michelle says that Kaya's Constable Zuvio Award is also Star Wars Resistance. Now, Kaya is in that age range, right?
Yeah. How old is
it? Four, five, six. I think she's around
Michelle,
six.
How old is Kaya now?
5 or 6. So. Yeah.
And last night, I was talking to this one little boy about 11 years old.
Okay.
And he loves Clone Wars. He loves Rebels. Okay, what's your take on Resistance? He said, meh.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. Doesn't really have the feel, he said, of the other animated shows and the movies.
Right.
That speaks volumes when your core audience is going, meh. And I know he said 6 to 8. The producers were hoping for a 6 to 11 audience
right
on this show, but no. This would have really worked well in 1979 on Saturday morning cartoons, wedged right in between the Bugs Bunny Roadrunner Hour and the Super Friends.
Yeah.
This would have been a good bridging show.
Nice. So we had our low points. We had our high points. We had some hashtags of 2018. So now let's look ahead to 2019. Richard, What are you looking forward to in 2019? I know I've got like six things listed because there's so much, but
all right,
go ahead.
I am looking forward to adding to our collection of discussions on Skywalking Through Neverland.
Aww.
Was it you who said the other night, Sarah, that I don't collect items anymore, collector's items.
Right.
I don't collect autographs.
Nope.
I collect discussions.
Yes, you do. You collect discussions with these amazing people who have been involved with Star Wars and with Disney, like, since the beginning. So that's what you collect now. And it's really great for our house because, you know, finite amount of space.
Right.
But the internet is infinite amount of space.
And there's so many people lined up, so many guests lined up for 2019 that I'm very excited for. And I know we had posted something on our Facebook group a few weeks ago saying that I got my white whale. I got my Skywalking Through Neverland white whale.
We haven't published it yet.
We haven't done it yet, but we have been talking. Should we go ahead?
No, I don't know. I think we should make people keep guessing.
Really?
No, let's make people
okay,
keep guessing.
All right. So,
we'll tease you now.
My birthday is January 16th. So we had scheduled with this guest to come up and see him because he lives right outside of Los Angeles.
Yeah.
And I would make my 50th birthday if we could go up and see him, meet him, and have a discussion with him on my birthday.
Yes.
And he said he's going to try his best.
Yay.
Because it's a Wednesday, so he might have to work. But if he doesn't, then he will honor that request. And I got to give a huge shout out to a new Skywalker who we've dubbed our bounty hunter. Skywalking bounty hunter. His name is Shamim Dana. And you might be seeing his name popping up quite a bit now in the Facebook group. And we put him on the trail of another future guest. This one I'll go ahead and reveal.
Okay.
Miko.
Oh.
Miko, who had produced and written the disco Star Wars albums, as well as Christmas in the Stars. He lives in Florida now. He hasn't been heard from in years.
And you tried to track him down
several times, and I could never reach him. I told this to Shamim. He said, okay, I'm on it. And like an hour later, got him.
Nice.
So Shamim is our Skywalking Through Neverland bounty hunter.
And your collection of, not interviews, of discussions.
Yes.
Keep growing.
Yeah, and I am so excited about it. People have never done podcasts before, and they're coming on our show, and I'm just over the moon.
Our collection keeps growing, and we can share it with you guys.
Mm-hmm.
We love that.
Mm-hmm.
All right.
You know what? We should name when we get like these interviews, like the digital vault or something to that effect.
I like, okay, so tweet at us, Skywalkers. What should we call these? That's a good one, though.
Like the segment name for someone that is very hard to get or track down.
Okay.
Like a treasure trove of something. Do you see where I'm going with this?
Yeah, I do. We'll have to think about it.
Yes.
But in the meantime.
Okay.
Can I say a couple things that I'm looking forward to in 2019?
You know, before you do that, can you just read what Michelle's looking forward to in 2019?
She's looking forward to Chicago, Chicago, Chicago! Yay. And so, let's see. Who else?
Hey, Michelle Whitless just joined us. Hey, Michelle.
Charles Halloran says episode 9 at the top of that list.
Okay.
And yeah.
Chicago. All right. So, Sarah, what are you looking forward to in 2019?
Captain Marvel!
We have no idea what threats are out there. We can't do this alone. We need you.
I'm not what you think I am.
I'm excited because I guess Captain Marvel is supposed to be like the greatest of all the Avengers. And it's a girl, and it's Captain Marvel, and she's wearing the red, white, and blue, which I love the red, white, and blue on any, like, I love Captain America, always loved Superman growing up. So anything red, white, and blue to me is very nostalgic in terms of superhero colors.
It's odd that it's red, blue, and yellow.
Oh, is that what it is?
It's like in Superman. It's not red, white, and blue.
Oh, that's right.
It's yellow.
Okay, well, it's the red and the blue and the yellow, I guess. Yeah, so there you go. That's what I was trying to say. I meant yellow when I said white.
Yeah, we all understood.
In my head.
Yeah, we all understood.
Okay. So very excited about that. And the fact that it comes out near, well, right before my birthday. So March 8th. And my birthday's March 10th. Mm-hmm. Yay. But Denny Townsend, looking forward to Star Wars Land, which definitely Galaxy's Edge.
Oh, big time.
So looking forward to that.
Well, you know what makes me really happy about the upcoming year in Star Wars is that it's not just on screen anymore.
No.
It's not just movies and television, but we're getting something like a land.
Yes.
So it really broadens out your fandom.
Yeah.
And, well, the hotel's not coming in 2019.
No.
But that's one more example of we're not just limited to stuff that's on the screen or stuff you can read, but video games are so immersive now. They're coming up with new VR experiences and the immersive adventures of the hotel as well as Star Wars Land, Galaxy's Edge. It'll get to a point where kids won't even know Star Wars as a movie anymore. It'll be all these immersive events.
Okay. I'm also looking forward to D23 Expo in August, which of course is the Disney con. So, woohoo! All right, do you have any other things you're looking forward to, or can I continue with my list here?
Oh, you got a pretty big list.
I do.
Let's go through your list.
Okay, so I have one last thing I want to bring up, and that is Disney Plus, the Disney streaming service. Okay, so I was looking this up in preparation for this podcast episode, and there was some things on there that I did not know were coming to Disney Plus. There's going to be a docuseries called Ink and Paint, which is going to highlight the women who worked at the famed ink and paint department at Walt Disney Studios during the 30s and beyond. So I am really excited about this. We get to learn more about this. Ugh. So cool. So, and that, of course, on Disney Plus, you're going to also get the Cassian Andor series. You're going to get The Mandalorian. You're going to get all these series from Marvel coming, you know, with the actual people from the film. So like the Loki series with Tom Hiddleston and all that stuff. So,
and Winter Soldier.
Yes.
And the Falcon series.
Yes. And there's even a Scarlet Witch series as well. So, yeah, this is going to be awesome. I'm so looking forward to this.
Hashtag never leaving the house.
Right?
Although, never leaving the house.
Now, not all those series might come out in 2019. We just know that the Disney Plus service is coming out in 2019.
Right.
So I will caveat that. But, yeah, very much to look forward to.
All right, Matt Clifton is looking forward to Star Wars Celebration Chicago and seeing everybody.
Woohoo! And Garrett Sessions is looking forward to episode 9 and the buildup leading to its debut. And yes, definitely. It's all this anticipation that makes things more fun.
Right.
That's one thing that social media is good for. And that is you can share in this anticipation of things with fellow fans. I love that.
And I would say that was that's number one on my list in 2019, of course, episode 9. And like you, Garrett, I love the buildup. I love the hype, which I'm sure is going to start Super Bowl weekend when we get our Star Wars episode 9 trailer.
You think?
It worked so well for Solo. So I think this is the time to premiere anything. If they didn't premiere it with Mary Poppins Returns, then it's going to be at the most watched television event of the year, which is the Super Bowl. And right now, that's really what they need. They need to change the conversation and people being upset with Star Wars and just being very excited about Star Wars.
Yeah.
We were all so excited about the Solo trailer and everyone saying, you know what, I didn't have any high hopes for this, but after seeing the trailer, I'm very, very excited. So that's what they're going to want to do with Episode 9 and change the conversation with Star Wars. And I can't wait for that either.
Yeah.
I'm sick and tired of all this fighting.
Yeah, because that'll hopefully unify fans, you know, have everyone talking about the same thing. So it'll change that conversation. Okay, I have one more thing that I think we've had enough of, and honestly, and I hate to say it, but I'm going to say it, Star Wars Resistance.
Oh, man.
This is a learning curve for me because this is actually the first Star Wars thing I didn't really like. And it actually made me realize that I don't need to like everything Star Wars, and it's okay. I'm still a Star Wars fan. I can still have Star Wars fan conversations. I don't have to like everything. And there's reasons. I mean, you know, I had like valid reasons why. And I liked Marvel Rising, you know, series much better than this one, Star Wars Resistance. So, you know, it just happens.
All right. Now, how would you place this with Forces of Destiny or the new Galaxy of Adventures series?
Galaxy. Oh, right. Now, well, the Galaxy Adventures, honestly, are so short. I like, to me, they don't even deserve a mention. I mean, I love the animation. Yeah. I love the animation, but I'm not the audience. I'm not the target audience for that.
Well, I love the fact that they'll take scenes from Star Wars and then give you backstory.
That is true.
Like when, with that short about longer. Han Solo meeting Luke and Obi-Wan at the cantina, and he mentions the Kessel Run, and they'll show scenes from Solo. So they'll incorporate what he's the backstory into what he's saying now. And I love that idea. But yeah, like you said, they're just too short.
Yeah.
But once again, they're made for the little kids who just need to, I think, take in these little clips and go, okay, now I know what he's talking about. If they put them in 30-minute shows, it might get lost.
Right.
But maybe if they put them all in like one 30-minute show, and so they can weave in and out of each other.
Oh, you mean you're talking about a playlist?
No, no.
Well, yes.
A playlist would be good, but like with Forces of Destiny, they bridged all these shorts with Maz Kanata.
Yes, that's what you're talking about.
Yeah,
okay.
So if they had all these shorts, all like, what, 15, which equals 15, 16 minutes.
And got rid of the pre-roll and the post-roll of each of them with that guy saying,
in the Star Wars galaxy, every day can be an adventure.
Yeah, and had maybe Yoda introducing each one.
Oh, yeah.
Yoda's talking to the younglings. That would have been perfect.
That would be cool.
I love the concept.
I have to hand that to you. Yes, that is a good concept.
Okay. Going back now, you really have a dislike for Resistance.
Right.
But you could also say that Forces of Destiny, Forces of Destiny weren't as goofy and silly and didn't leave big plot holes in every episode.
Well, they were short too, but they had the dolls, which, I mean, that to me, when I say Forces of Destiny, I'm mostly talking about the dolls.
Right.
And not necessarily the series, but although those were cute.
It was also made for a very young audience.
Right.
But I don't recall as many plot holes in each of these shorts.
And we even got to see, didn't we see someone from the Star Wars Holiday Special?
What? No, Jackson.
Jackson.
Oh, see, there you go. That's
from like.
Therefore, hashtag I love Forces of Destiny. Hashtag Jackson lives.
From the classic Marvel Star Wars comics. Yeah. So that was cool. Well, let's move on. Do you have a personal goal in your fandom for 2019?
Yes, I do. And I don't want to, I'm sorry for keep having to say this, but
there is
a lot on the plate, which I don't want to jinx right now, but stuff under the Skywalking Through Neverland banner, stuff other than podcasting.
Yeah.
That we do have in mind, but once again, and hopefully we'll reveal a lot coming up, but we're going to expand outside of podcasting to doing more stuff.
More articles, more stuff.
Yeah, and just in other stuff and other mediums.
Okay.
But I believe in jinxing, so
yeah.
I'm not going to jinx ourselves.
Let's just tease.
Yeah, and as well as doing more podcasting, like I was saying earlier, we have some really fun guests coming up, and I really want to get back to classic Marvel Star Wars comics with Randy Martinez and Step in Time.
Yes.
2018 threw a huge curveball at us.
Right.
With this kitchen leak, which destroyed our house.
Yeah, so we had this whole unplanned house renovation. So that really takes a lot out of you and a lot out of your time. So luckily this year, we're sitting on a nice new floor and crossing fingers with all the plumbing. So yeah, we're looking forward to really focusing more on skywalking. And that is really, I mean, the Skywalking Force, you're helping so much with that.
You can't say that enough. Now, Matthew Rumpf says, personal goal for me is making my first costume for myself.
Ooh, what
is this? But also for my daughter so we can go to cons as a pair.
Yay!
That's awesome.
That is so much. That is exciting. My first costume I made for myself was Jedi Tink. And that it was so empowering and so cool to be able to say, I made this. So Awesome. Awesome. I'm so excited for you.
Now, I know, Sarah, we talked about this earlier last year.
Okay.
But I want to do some cosplaying at Celebration Chicago. I haven't cosplayed in since 1979.
All right.
When it was just called dressing up. I would go to all the BossCon conventions in Boston as Luke Skywalker, Return of the Jedi Luke Skywalker, my black outfit. I loved it. And I really haven't. Oh, no, wait a minute. Star Wars Celebration 6 or 7, was it? 5? I don't know. They're all blending together. That you were Slave Leia and I was Jabba the Hutt.
That was 6. Yes.
6. Okay.
Yeah.
In my inflatable
2012.
In my inflatable Jabba costume.
That was fun.
So there's some outfits that we talked about.
Yes, and that's why we're going on our diet.
Yes.
Oh, okay, here's some other Skywalker sharing. Tony Darth Cyrix says, I plan on also podcasting more this year. Charles
nice.
Halloran says, creating more Star Wars fan-related art. Awesome.
Oh, see, Star Wars just provokes so many people to bring their creative side out.
Yes, and that, for me, my personal goal is to create more designs for t-shirts, stickers, holidays, maybe different movies coming up. Like, hopefully a new design each, do I want to say month? Maybe every 2 months. Okay.
Okay.
No. But I'm putting it out there. Don't do that.
Okay.
No, I want to focus more energy on creating art.
Hey, Michelle said, what if all the Skywalkers could cosplay as a group in Chicago?
Oh.
Oh, you, hello?
Hoojib hop number 2.
Amanda Boggan got to it before I did. Oh,
yes.
The Hoojib hop 2.
This is going to be a week before Easter. So you know what? We
okay.
need a Hoojib hop number 2.
All right. Seal the deal with a high five. All right. That's what we're going to see. Look at that.
Oh my gosh. Okay. If you guys don't know what the Hoojib hop was, it's when we wore Hoojib ears that were handmade.
By Amanda Bond.
And there was a bunch of us Skywalkers who met on the Sunday of Celebration, which was Easter. And we met in the show floor and we like hopped around to each different booth, like Randy Martinez.
Steve Sansweet. All of our friends.
And we met other random people along the way and took pictures with them. And it was so much fun. We even took pictures with like a chicken Darth Vader or something.
Yeah, from Family Guy.
Yes.
Yeah, Chicken Fett.
So there's some really wacky pictures, but it was great.
Yeah. So who still has their Hoojib ears?
I know we do.
We got
somewhere.
Yeah, some of them. They're around here somewhere. I just saw them.
Yeah.
So yeah. All right. That's going to be a thing on that Sunday.
Okay.
We'll do the Hoojib hop number 2.
Woohoo!
So,
all right.
Okay. That's something I'm looking forward to in 2019 now.
Okay. And now I would really love to learn guitar with you, Richard, because apparently we both want to do this. And there's a music shop down the street that also offers lessons. So you know
what?
Yeah.
Yeah. Didn't we make that promise when we were talking to Eric Walker
yes.
on our last show?
Yeah.
That we're going to learn guitar.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. We're going to look into this.
Right
yes, after we're
do.
Done recording, we're going to look into this.
Yes. Woohoo!
Because there could be some musical surprises at Star Wars Celebration Chicago that we've been talking about. See, a lot of stuff we're planning.
Yeah.
But once again, hashtag jinx it and you'll screw it up.
Okay. Woohoo!
What would you think will be your hashtag in 2019?
Okay. My hashtag is hashtag Star Wars Landline Achieved. Bam! And we'll have gone to Star Wars Galaxy's Edge several times by then.
I'll look back at 2019 and I'll say, my hashtag is going to be, just like Boss Nass said in Phantom Menace, being friends. All right, so hashtag being friends.
Meaning no divisiveness?
No divisiveness. We're all going to be friends. And we're going to say, did 2018 really happen? Did we really argue about all that stuff?
Oh, yeah. Oh, so everyone coming together.
Everyone coming together. We're all going to be being friends.
Come together. Right now.
That was one of the greatest monkey songs ever.
Over Star Wars.
Well, taking that last train to Clarksville. All right, Skywalkers. Well, thank you very much for joining us and for telling us your 2018 high points and low points and hashtags and what you're looking forward to in 2019. So, Sarah, before we really, really wrap it up, let's go ahead and give a shout out to the Skywalking Force.
Shout outs, Skywalker shout outs. Which Skywalkers get props from here in Neverland? Who was tweeted out?
Shout out.
Who was photoballed?
Shout out.
Who was shared a post?
Shout out.
We want to give a huge shout out to all of our Skywalking Force, and at the contribution level of $5 or more per month, you get a shout out on this show once a month. So, January shout outs, here we go. Peter and Norma Heitman. Thanks, Mom and Dad.
Thanks to Kurt Emery,
Mike Sanders,
Terry Lee,
Jennifer Cole,
Brian Sims,
Bryn McKinnon,
the Hunt family,
Anthony Kakias,
Reynold Gobiel,
Patrick Pine,
Michelle,
Laura Bryce,
and Christopher Marino.
Awesome. Now, if you would like more Skynet in your life, Skywalkers, please check out skywalkingforce.com. That's where we plus up our content and offer little extras just for you. And for example, Richard, we just put out a new Skywalking Force episode, and one of the most requested extras is more content. So we just sat down and recorded a commentary last week to Home Alone while we watched. And it was really, really fun to share stories from our first time watching the film, for me as a kid, and for you, Richard, as a young adult. And we also shared fun facts and trivia as we watched and listened, of course, to that awesome John Williams score. So to hear this and previous bonus content, become a part of the Skywalking Force. And you can go do that by going to skywalkingforce.com.
And we'd love to hear your suggestions, too, about what we can do, commentaries.
Extra content.
We can do film commentaries on other films. We want to hear from you. What do you want to hear us gab on about 2 hours?
Exactly. It's really fun.
It is fun.
We enjoy it.
Yeah. So we sat by a fire, had some eggnog and cider, and just watched one of the perennial favorites, holiday favorites now of all time, Home Alone.
Woohoo! All right, Skywalkers, well, that wraps up episode 234 of
Skywalking Through Neverland.
We'd, of course, like to thank all of you Skywalkers and you facehuggers who got to join us today. There was many of you sharing all of your thoughts, so we really, really love that.
Love all your input. Now, there is one thing we want to mention regarding Star Wars Resistance.
Yes, we have Resistance Flyby, you know, which our series that was talking about that show. And we just, unfortunately, are not going to be able to cover the last two episodes. We're basically ending our Resistance Flyby show because we want to focus our time and energy on more content that we really, really are excited about.
Right. And yeah. So you watch we'll still watch it and have a good time, but we want to focus on other stuff now.
Yeah. Like adding to our discussion collection.
Yes. And putting these discussions in our digital vault.
Yeah. And doing more art and all kinds of things. So
new name coming soon.
Yes. Yes. So there's a lot more that we can focus our attention on. Now, Skywalkers, if you'd like to support us in a different way, please share the show with a friend, or you can click on the links on our website, skywalkingthroughneverland.com, to Pozu Shoes, Oppo Suits, or tpublic.com, and then that will give us a little bit of extra money there when you buy something from them, which is really great.
If anyone's going to go to a live event, a celebration event, or a press event, put on one of these Oppo Suits, they'll pick you out of a crowd.
Mm-hmm. And we also have our YouTube channel, youtube.com/skywalkingthroughneverland.
Now, if you want even more Skywalking Through Neverland, you can go over there to jedinews.co.uk and Fanthatrax, and you can find us there.
Now, we are at Skywalking Pod on Twitter and Instagram. We have our lovely Facebook group, which if you search Facebook for Skywalking Through Neverland group, you can request to join and answer the questions that pop up. You can also email us, share@skywalkingthroughneverland.com. What are your hashtags for 2018 and 2019? What was your fandom highlight and low point? So just let us know.
And as we always ask, please go over there to Apple Podcasts or Stitcher and leave us a review. We would love to hear what you have to say, and we love the feedback.
Now, stay tuned for bloopers and other fun conversation after the credits. There was some fun bloopers today. Not hashtag Sarah swears. What else did I do, though?
The day is young.
Oh.
and always remember to have a great 2019. And
never land on Alderaan.
Some imagination, huh?
To our Skywalkers and Tweetwalkers, thanks for listening. Skywalking Through Neverland is created and produced by Richard and Sarah Woloski. Original music by Rob Dellinger. Creative consultant, Mark Augushowitz. Technical advisor, Peter Heitman. Facebook administrators, Donald Wicks, Joey Pittman, and Norma Heitman.
Skywalking Through Neverland is intended for entertainment and information purposes only. Any sounds, music, and clips played during this podcast are the property of their copyright holders. All original content is property of Skywalking Through Neverland, all rights reserved. Sorry, had to be said.
This is what you can look forward to on our year-end wrap-up episode 234 of Skywalking...
What?
You're not supposed to say it.
No.
Oh.
Have you forgotten already?
I have. Whoops. Okay, well, bloopers. Ready?
No.
What is
that? The gardener just showed up.
Wait, wasn't the gardener already here?
Oh, he's waiting outside until we start recording.
Oh.
You know who our gardener is? Secret Squirrel.
Yeah.
If he can't take away our recording devices, he's going to stop us from recording. He's going to be making sounds and noises.
Okay. Well, luckily, it won't be picked up on the mic. All right, here we go. This is what we can... This...
Yeah, it's been a while, people.
Yes. Hashtag hot mess.
Yes, yes.
Thank you.
All right. Well, while Sarah steps away, Michelle, you're right. How did I miss this? Hashtag Richard was the rebel spy. Oh, my. You know what? It's just been so long since I really put in any serious thought into me being the rebel spy. Didn't even think about it anymore. So, yes, when that will happen, I don't know. Should I talk about it and jinx it? Or should I affirm it? Oh, there's a whole different side to this now. You can jinx it or you can make it an affirmation. Oh, this is we're getting to a whole new level now. So, while you were away, Sarah, we discovered something new. Mm-hmm. It's not going to be... We can talk about some things... Because that means if you talk about it, you're affirming it, you're putting it out into the universe that it's going to happen. And Michelle said that hashtag Richard was the rebel spy.
Oh, there you go. Mm-hmm. This will be your year, mm-hmm. 2019.
Mm-hmm.
It's also our 10-year wedding anniversary.
That's right.
Yay.
10 years ago, when it comes to October 25th, on that date, 2019 will be our 10th. Wedding anniversary.
All right, so let's move on to our next question, which is who or what have we had enough of and don't need to see or do or hear in 2019?
All right, I'm going to just say fandom division and leave it there. Mm. Enough of that.
Okay.
And so help me if any of these haters make a scene at Star Wars Celebration Chicago.
Yeah.
Gonna throw them out in the snow.
All right, I'm gonna
say they will not get a Wookiee hug. I can guarantee you that.
Denied.
Yeah, I'm gonna walk around with a big red button. If you make me push this big red button, it's not gonna be pretty.
Mm. Okay.
Go ahead. I'm done.
Okay. Well, I have two things. My first thing is, I don't want to see more crowds at Disneyland.
All right, not gonna happen. So move on.
I know. Gonna happen. I just had to say it. Okay.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Of all years, 2019.
I know.
Hey, you guys hear what Sarah said? Yeah, no more crowds.
Thanks.
Forget about going to Star Wars Land. Galaxy's Edge. Nope. Sarah doesn't want us there.
Oh, I think Michelle said looking forward to looking for Leia in 2019. Oh, and Rachel definitely agrees with you about fandom division. Yes.
Enough.
Yay.
So, Sarah, that is a perfect way to wrap things up.